Money Brown, man. Erickson Jr. Boy, Money Brown, he get a lot of money, that's why I call him Money Brown.
What's good, Money Brown TV? What up, what up?
Yeah.
I want to give a shout out to Money Brown TV. Thank you so much for everything.
Hey, this is Ryan Garcia here. Shout out to Money Brown TV. And keep punching, baby. This is Steven Espinosa from Showtime Sports. Shout out to Money Brown TV. What's up, Brian Custer from Showtime Championship Boxing? I got to give a big shout out to Money Brown TV.
Give a shout out to Money Brown TV from the Punchline.
Hey, yeah, Money Brown, we're on the way up, baby. Yeah, Tuzzle coming up, baby. Get us now.
Yo, 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 what's going on at the fight? Well, this your boy Money back with another one, man. And this one here is on the hottest Mexican fighter in the game, Canelo Alvarez, the four-division world champion, the unified WBC, WBO, and WBA super middleweight world champion. And we have Oscar De La Hoya back once again. We all know Oscar, the six-division world champion, legendary fighter, right? Golden, the CEO of Golden Boy Promotions. And now Oscar is back, and he's hating on Canelo once again, but he's trying to use Eddie Hearn as the guinea pig this time. I want y'all to listen to what Oscar did. He had put out what Eddie Hearn had said about Canelo Alvarez when the clenbuterol situation. Y'all listen to what Eddie Hearn had to say, and I'm going to get back and give y'all this great assessment, family.
I keep saying, you know, was he cheating or did he eat some bad meat? When I say that, everyone looks at me like I'm thick. People say, are you stupid? I'm like, I don't know. I don't know enough about it. But what I do know is if you fail a test, you have to live with the consequences. Taking away the six-month ban, Canelo will always be labelled as a drug cheat, whether he did it or not. And that's much worse than any ban. You know? So 6 months, 8 months, 10 months, it doesn't really matter. He's going to fight again. But what he will have to live with is the fact that every Instagram post, every Twitter post, every interview, every member of the public he walks past will look at him as a cheat in boxing. And that will always take away his legacy in the sport. And that is a lot more crushing than any fine that can be delivered.
Everybody, Oscar De La Hoya came out with this post on Twitter, and he said, look at your stupid promoter accusing, and I'm always in your corner defending. Hashtag ungrateful. Hashtag ungrateful. Hashtag unmotherfucking grateful. Now, I want y'all to understand this. Oscar De La Hoya came out with this post around Canelo Alvarez's birthday to sabotage Canelo happiness, bro. He came out to sabotage Canelo happiness, and he's trying to destroy what Canelo and Eddie Hearn got going on at the moment. I repeat, Oscar De La Hoya is trying to sabotage Canelo happiness on his birthday and trying to destroy what Canelo and Eddie Hearn got going on at the moment. Now, like we all say, man, Canelo came out, he's guilty of taking clenbuterol. Nobody can take that away from him, right? But Oscar De La Hoya, you defended him. You defended him, right? So you coming out talking about that, oh, look at your stupid promoter now. First of all, Eddie Hearn is just they co-promote. He's not Canelo promoter, as we want to say they co-promoted. So Canelo is not signed to no fucking matchroom, homie. Canelo is not signed to matchroom. But Oscar De La Hoya, you did this on some snakish shit. You a snake in the grass, bro. You're a backstabber. And you coming out and you doing this on some snakish shit, on some petty shit, right? And you bring it out around this man's birthday, and you trying to, throw salt in the game. You trying to throw salt in the game, bro. It's not going to work, Oscar. It's not going to work, bro. Look, you're supposed to be training for a fight, homie. Ain't you trying to get a big-time fight because, you know, you ain't got the Canelo Alvarez payday coming through no more? So you got to go out there and you got to fight to keep Golden Boy afloat because you don't have the, you know, the names on Golden Boy to keep Golden Boy afloat like Canelo was doing, right? Ain't that's what's going down right now, Oscar? You got to get out of retirement and fight your goddamn self. You're trying to make it sound good, but you got to get out and fight. Canelo Alvarez is fit to be guaranteed his biggest guaranteed money in his entire career. I want y'all to let that settle in for a minute. Let this settle in. Canelo Alvarez is about to get his biggest guarantee of his entire fucking career. And who has he been up under for his entire career? Huh? Who has he been up under for his entire career? Huh? Oscar De La Hoya. Oscar De La Hoya, right? Now he linked up with Eddie Hearn, right? Co-promoting. Did the last three fights on his own. About to do his first fight with Fox Pay-Per-View with Al Heyman. and he's getting his fucking biggest guaranteed purse of his entire career. Y'all think Oscar De La Hoya ain't jealous about that shit? Y'all think Oscar De La Hoya ain't trying to sabotage that? Y'all think he don't read the newspapers and see what's going on? You feel me? And now you come out with this shit, trying to bring up this Clenbuterol shit, the shit on Canelo legacy and all that, right? Now, Eddie Hearn, when he spoke what he spoke, I know he thought in a million years that he'd be working with Canelo Alvarez right now. I'm going to repeat this, family. When Eddie Hearn spoke what he spoke, I know he thought in a million years, right, that he won't be working with Canelo Alvarez because he thought that was Oscar De La Hoya prize in possession. Like, Oscar, there's no way Oscar can fuck up with Canelo Alvarez. There's no way. If anything, he's going to cater to Canelo. He's going to do whatever Canelo asks for. He's going to do what he got to do to secure that bag. That's like Eddie Hearn fucking up with Anthony Joshua and Anthony Joshua going over to fucking Golden Boy. You understand what I'm saying? That's like Eddie Hearn fucking up with Eddie Joshua. You don't fuck up with your biggest entity that's on your fucking promotion company, bro. You show them love and you treat them right. You feel me? But Oscar, you the backstabber. You feel it some type of way because Canelo done left you, bro. And you trying to sabotage that man's peace. You're trying to sabotage his peace, bro. That's exactly what you're doing, Oscar. That's exactly what you're doing. And you're trying to do it in the snakiest and the slickest way. So now, your job is to, oh, man, I'm going to fuck up what him and Eddie got going on. So let me show him what Eddie said. Huh? Look what Eddie said, guys. Hey, look what Eddie said. And look at Canelo. He's riding with Eddie, eh? But look what Eddie said. You see what I'm saying? Now, as y'all see, I say, you can never let anything distract you from your main objective, man. My only goal is to be great. That's all I want. That's all I ever aspire to be. Greatness is something nobody can ever take away from you, no matter what happens. So I put all my energy and focus into my craft. That is a quote from the great Larry Fitzgerald, man. I linked it to this right here on her because that's what Canelo need to be doing right now, bro. That's what Canelo need to be paying attention to. Focusing on his happiness, focusing on being great, and doing what you got to do to be great, bro. Doing what you got to do to be great and not worrying about a bitter-ass promoter who you going to beat the shit out of in the future. I'm telling y'all right now, Canelo going to beat the fuck out of Oscar De La Hoya in the future. But right now, man, you still got things to achieve on your list. You know what I'm saying? And you can arguably the greatest Mexican fighter of all time. So stick to your role, Canelo, doing what you're doing. And don't worry about this old, we can call Oscar a lot of things. But don't worry about this backstab mistake, man. Don't worry about this guy that's trying to steal your happiness because he's not happy, bro. We seen him in the Mike Tyson shit. We seen him say he's not happy. You know, all I wanted was a hug, you know? I mean, I told my father I love you. And, you know, I pet him on the back. And I'm not here to try to shit on nobody upbringing or their term because we all go through shit. But you see him on the Mike Tyson shit and you can see where all this jealousy and bitterness and all this hatred come from, bro. You know what I mean? He's not happy, man. Oscar, he acting like he's happy in life, but he's probably not, bro. Maybe he is, but why keep hating on Canelo Alvarez, Oscar? Why keep throwing shots at Canelo Alvarez when Canelo is not fucking worrying about you, man? Canelo is worrying about becoming undisputed at 168 pounds, creating more history for his legacy so he could be the greatest Mexican fighter of all time. He's trying to put himself in the history books as the greatest fighter of all time, taking a torch from Julio Cesar Chavez Sr., who passed him the torch that you got jealous of and say that he didn't pass the torch. Oh, no, I know, Sr. Oh, no, I know. That's my compadre, eh? No, I know he didn't say that willingly, and I know he didn't mean that. Get your jealous ass up out of here. I know he didn't mean that. How you know he didn't mean it, bro? How you know? When he clearly said it right there in front of motherfucking thousands of Mexican fans. Thousands and thousands of Mexican fans, fighters, and reporters, and everybody else. So he didn't mean it, Oscar. So Julio just talking out his ass. He just want to say some nice things to Canelo Alvarez because he just started watching the fight. He let Canelo come up in the corner and coach him because why? Right? Like, you want them to stay bitter with each other, bro. That way you can go back and have somebody to gossip with your little gossiping ass. Yeah, Tyson, you know? I don't know, man. I don't know. Like, I just want to fight again. Your ass don't want to fight again. You got to fight again. You feel me? You got to fight again. But this is a shot, everybody. This is Oscar De La Hoya being a snake that he is, right? Trying to go behind his dude back. You see, you know, he's going hand in hand with Eddie Hearn, who I don't want Canelo to trust neither, right? Don't trust none of these motherfuckers because none of these damn promoters is good. But right now he's working with Eddie Hearn, and he just got his biggest guarantee. So we understand what he gonna get on the back end. And Oscar De La Hoya is jealous of that, bro. He's jealous of that. You feel me? Oh, I've been with Canelo for so long. I made him so much money. But now you see that he's finna make more money without your motherfucking ass. He about to make more money without you. You feel me? And that says a lot, bro. That says a lot. And that goes against Oscar De La Hoya and what he was doing with Canelo at Golden Boy. You feel me? Now Canelo finna make way more money than he was making when he was with your ass, like Floyd Mayweather did when he left Top Rank, like you did when you left Top Rank. Now Canelo is about to have his run, and he's about to fill up his fucking coffin for his generational wealth. So maybe in the future, he can have, guess what, Canelo Promotions, if he really want, and steal fighters away from your ass. And guess what? Canelo can pass the torch to that fighter in Mexico that's haven't been born yet. You understand what I'm saying? Not Oscar De La Hoya, who trying to get fighters and just rob them out of their fucking money all day and lie to them like you lied to Canelo. If you lied to Canelo, you damn sure lied to everybody else on your roster, right? So Ryan Garcia, you better take heed. Virgil Ortiz, you better take heed. Jaime McGee, you better take heed. Speedy Rashidi, you better take heed. Y'all better pay attention to what's going on and understand why Canelo left this man. You understand me? Understand why Canelo left this man. Oscar De La Hoya, you need to quit it, bro. Stop hating on Canelo. Quit throwing these petty-ass shots. Quit trying to break up this man's relationships or what he got going on with his business, bro. That shit is not going to work. It only make you look even foolish. It make you look that much more desperate. Oh, man, let me go find something that this guy said about Canelo and put it out there. And look, Canelo, you see, he talked bad about you. He talked way more shit about you than me. No, motherfucker, what you did was way more backstabbing. Stealing his fucking money, bro. Stealing his money and not giving a fuck if Canelo gets sued or not, and if the man probably end up in jail or not, because you're only worried about your goddamn self, bro. You know what I mean? You're only worried about yourself. So everyone, this is Oscar De La Hoya coming out around this man's birthday time, where this man is enjoying his peace, right? Enjoying his fucking peace, and Oscar trying to steal this man's peace away from him by bringing out this Clenbuterol shit and try to bring that shit back into the mix to try to shit on Canelo Alvarez's career, bro. But that shit is not gonna work. Canelo is still making history. The man is gonna be great. The man is gonna be the greatest Mexican fighter of all time when it's all said and done. And there's nothing you can do about that, Oscar De La Hoya. Nothing you can do about that. So continue hate. Canelo will continue to be great. He's gonna surpass you. You feel me? He's gonna surpass you. And there's nothing you can do about that. At the end of the day, I don't give a damn what nobody say. You feel me? Canelo will surpass Oscar De La Hoya. Canelo will go down as the greatest Mexican fighter of all time as long as he continue to do what he do. Period. Shouts out to Canelo. Keep being great, man. Go do your thing. Oscar De La Hoya, quit being the biggest fucking hater alive right now, bro, because it's looking sad and pathetic on you, bro. And when Canelo get you in that ring in the future, like I keep telling y'all, he gonna beat the blood out of your ass. Period. Until then, it's your boy Money. It's the NSBC moving. Ain't nobody safe in these streets. Hit them thumbs up. Subscribe to the channel if you want to donate OG Money on Cash App. TreyHampton52@gmail.com on PayPal. If not, just tell a friend, tell a friend. Hit the subscribe button. Like, comment, share the video. And y'all know how your boy get down, man. Big dog status, family.